You're watching CBC.
Over the next 2 hours, we're going to redefine smart. Four amazing Canadians and you at home are about to be put to the test. And this is not your everyday IQ test. This is about being smart in every aspect of your life. We'll be looking at six different kinds of smarts: social, musical, physical, visual, linguistic, and logical. You put them all together, and you've got Canada's smartest person. It's going to be exciting. Attaboy!
Wow!
Keep going! It's going to be grueling. That's not right.
Ah.
And it's going to get physical. Go! Being smart has never been this fun. Marshall, I saw you mouth, oh my God. And you get to play along at home with Canadians across the country. So grab your smartphones and computers right now and go to cbc.ca/smartestperson to find out how smart you are. 10 challenges, one title. It's time to find out who is Canada's smartest person. And welcome to Canada's Smartest Person. Tonight, we're gonna blow the lid off old school thinking about who's smart. When I was a teacher, I saw a lot of kids who may not have always felt smart. Kind of myself. I didn't always feel smart either. But now, there's a new way to assess smarts. It's called multiple intelligence theory. It's a new way to measure brain power. And with more, here's our intelligence expert.
Hey, Jerry. The theory of multiple intelligences says that there's more than one way to be smart. If you're catching a fly ball, or selling cars, or playing music, these represent different ways that we can use our minds in everyday life. Tonight, you're going to get a chance to see the ways in which you particularly excel. Canada's smartest person will excel in all areas.
Let's take a look at the six categories of intelligence that we will be testing tonight. They are musical, visual, logical, physical, social, and linguistic. And tonight, we're gonna put our finalists through the ringer in each of these categories to find out who is Canada's smartest person. Now, you're probably wondering how we found our finalists.
I'm the baddest, I'm the best, I'm the best.
Last fall, you had the opportunity to nominate yourself or someone you know. And it turns out, there are a lot of smart Canadians.
Maybe it's the results of achieving a 96 percentile score, 720 on the GMAT, scoring 132 IQ on the SCAT test.
I'm actually a member of Mensa Canada.
I'm also a designer and fabricator.
We received thousands of applicants that range from inspiring.
He's a teacher and he loves his kids.
Not bad so far.
To brilliant.
Confutatis maledictis.
To let's just say, offbeat.
I'm all brains.
We use special multiple intelligence tests to narrow down the field. So let's meet our finalists.
Boom! Hi, my name is Greg Frankson. I am a spoken word artist, professionally known as Ritalin. There ain't nobody smarter than Canada's smartest person.
I work in schools and community. Three areas that I focus on are youth, anti-discrimination, and mental health. I wake up every day knowing that I'm gonna be working on my passion. I grew up in a metro housing project, and my mom, she raised us as a single parent. She made the sacrifices necessary for my sister and I to be successful. I don't have any doubt that I could be Canada's smartest person. I have the linguistic ability, I have that musical soul, and I ain't playing around.
Hi, my name's Laura Swan, and I think that I'm Canada's smartest person because I'm currently an atomic physics graduate student. I was formerly a nuclear physicist. I design lasers. I worked as a journalist in Africa. I worked in a hospital in Vietnam, and I'm only 23 years old. Growing up Chinese Canadian, my mom and my dad were like tiger parents, but my drive for success was more from my siblings. I would see them doing well. And then I'd be like, okay, I think I can beat them. I can one-up these guys.
Hello, everyone. My name is Marshall Carroll. I'm from Winnipeg. I'm a high school science teacher and a part-time university lecturer in chemistry. One of my hobbies is collecting stamps. People think that that's a nerdy or a geeky thing to do. I think I might be the oldest person in this competition. Anyways, I think the others haven't gone through puberty yet. I've gone through it 4 times. I believe I'm Canada's smartest person because I'm well-balanced in all the multiple intelligences. When I'm teaching a typical chemistry class and I've got my groove on, we're juggling, we're singing, I'm dancing. When the kids are getting it, when the kids are smiling, when they're putting their iPods away, coming up with their own ideas, when they're improvising, that's good, and that's learning.
My name is Peter Diakowski. I'm from Vancouver, British Columbia, and I play left guard for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Most people have some preconceived notions about football players. We're dumb jocks, big meatheads. There's a few of us who actually have a head on our shoulders and use it as more than just a battering ram. You know, all my life I've had tremendous success with the ladies. I think it's due to a great combination of, you know, athleticism, hunkiness. The stakes are high. The other competitors need to be scared because I'm bigger than them, I'm stronger than them.
I'm gonna win because I think I have just enough in all the different intelligences to put me over the top.
I'm the youngest here. I'm the only female here. I'm not going to lose to them. I just can't.
Laura, Marshall, Peter, look out. It's on!
Let's hear it for our 4 finalists. From Toronto, spoken word artist and poet, Greg Frankson. From Mississauga, student and avid gamer, Laura Soon. From Vancouver, Hamilton Tiger Cat, Peter Diakowski. And from Winnipeg, high school teacher, Marshall Carroll. This is exciting. This is gonna be one of the biggest, most pressure-filled nights of your lives. And all of Canada's watching, no pressure. Let me explain how this works. You'll compete in challenges across 6 categories of intelligence. You can earn a maximum of 10 points per intelligence. At the end of the evening, the participants with the highest 2 scores will move on to the spectacular finale, and only one of you can be named Canada's smartest person. Now, for those of you at home, you can play along too. There are 2 ways. Go right now to cbc.ca/smartestperson, or for a more enhanced experience, pick up your iPhone or iPad and download the Canada Smartest Person app. And at the end of the night, you'll see how you did compared to everyone else across Canada and compared to our participants in the studio. All right, let's get to it. What will our first intelligence of the night be? It is linguistic. It's all about communicating with words. Journalists, politicians, and authors are all pros. Let's have a look at how linguistic smarts play out in our everyday lives.
Hi, I'm Matt.
I'm Naomi.
And we've been together for 3 years.
Yeah, I think we get along really well because we have similar intelligences. We're sort of the same person.
For instance, the most important part of a marriage is communication.
Sensuality. Communication. Yeah.
Communicate really well.
Yeah.
Hey, come on, we're lacing. Let's go.
Lacing?
Late racing. Come on. Oh, you're making me really angerified. You're such a downer.
I don't know.
Judgmental downer. We're gonna have to have a discourage about this, you know?
A discussion about our marriage.
Yes.
Got it. Wait, what?
Understanding PartnerCom and using Fasties for word blurbs has really been fantastic. Great. I've learned a lot.
I have no idea what he just said.
What's that?
Nothing.
There will be 2 challenges of linguistic intelligence. The first is called word mix. Here's how it works. There will be 3 30-second rounds increasing in difficulty. In each round, 6 letters will appear on the screen. Your goal is to make as many 3 or more letter words as you can using the keypad in front of you. For the challenge, first place wins 5 points, second place gets 3, third place gets 2, and the participant who finishes last gets none. For those of you playing along at home, click or tap on Word Mix right now. Watch for the countdown in the corner of your screen, and when you see the go prompt, press go to begin. Participants, are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Let's do this.
Those of you at home, are you ready? Please put 30 seconds on the clock. Round 1 of Word Mix will begin in 3, 2, 1, go. time. Please stop. There were 20 possible words there. All right, let's see how everyone did. Laura,
yeah.
7, Peter, 6, Marshall, 5. Tight race.
Not so strong, man.
Was it harder than you thought, Greg?
Yeah, well.
Laura, you're leading.
Yep, not surprised.
You're not surprised. I like it. Peter likes it. Peter likes that chirping. Time for round two. For those of you at home, watch for the go prompt. Let's put 30 seconds back on the clock. We will begin. 3, 2, 1, go. Time. Stop typing. There were 19 possible words available in that round. Here we go. Now we're going to look at your two-round cumulative score. Let's see how you're doing. All right. Marshall, creeping up.
We're creeping up. It's okay.
On final round of word mix. Those of you at home, get ready. Watch for the go prompt. 30 seconds on the clock. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. There were 14 possible words. Let's see them. Between all three rounds, so who won? Let's take a look. Hey! Peter! Marshall and Laura, close behind. Greg, really?
I had words in my head. They just didn't translate on the iPad.
You got to battle back then. So based on your placement, let's see the number of points you'll take from this challenge. Peter in first place with 5. Marshall and Laura each get 3. No points for the last place, but lots of challenges left. We're on our way to finding out who is Canada's smartest person. And how are you doing at home? Well, we've only just begun.
Oh, it was terrible. I mean, I'm not good at word mixes, not my strength at all, but I'm hoping that the next challenge will be better and there's lots of time to come back.
Coming up, Linguistic Smarts continues with special guest Sean Cullen.
Whoa! This elixir.
What you hear will leave you speechless.
Shotgun in a townhouse. Very entertaining.
Canada's smartest person will be right back.
Help wanted. Young Canadians are finding very few job opportunities, let alone career paths, opening up before them. CBC News' Marissa Draghetti looks at just how difficult it is for 18 to 24-year-olds tonight on The National.
It's big. It's very big. It's Toyota's biggest event of the year, Toyota Red Tag Days. On now with big cash incentives of up to $5,000 on select models. Toyota Red Tag Days on now.
Canada's Economic Action Plan is helping create jobs and growth.
I got grants to help pay for my apprenticeship, but getting this job is where it really paid off.
It's pretty cool work, too.
Thank you.
And I got support to help retrain for a new job. It is great to be back to work.
In a fragile global economy, Canada has a plan focused on jobs and growth. To find out more, visit actionplan.gc.ca. A message from the Government of Canada.
CLR makes quick cleaning of all your messes and turns chore time into your time. Take that clogged shower head, dip it in CLR, and done. It's running like new. CLR's patented formula doesn't waste time. Swish CLR in your coffee pot to get rid of hard water deposits, and it looks like new. A half cup in the washer and dishwasher keeps them running clean and trouble-free. CLR dissolves white crusty calcium and lime buildup on your humidifier filter fast. A quick wipe has this rusty bike restored. Old-looking patio furniture looks great again. A few scrubs and CLR's patented formula zaps through tough rust stains on concrete and stucco, so you can get back to your day. CLR is safe for the environment, too. Wherever there's dirt, CLR is ready to take it on. Turn chore day into your day with CLR.
At Canadian Tire, Home Hardware, Superstores, Loblaws, Rona, Zeller, Safeway, Shoppers, Co-op, Timbermart, Ace, True Hardware, V&S, London Drugs, Home Depot.
This is my favorite color.
$4.
Okay, this is my most favorite color. See? Look, yellow. White. Seriously, this is my most favorite color.
I could probably get you a whole bunch.
100% cotton tees and leggings, all at $4. All backed by our George Kids quality guarantee. Walmart.
The car you can count on, the Toyota Corolla, has the lowest cost of ownership over 10 years. And now, it's even better for 2012. Get a great deal on one during Toyota Red Tag Days. On now.
Wise men say, only fools run.
Unleash the chaos. New Lax Anarchy. For him.
And for her.
Also available in shampoo and shower gel.
All new Monday.
Love field trips.
Let's get on the bus.
8 hours spare today.
There's a few things you have to do.
They have to learn.
Take care of the kids.
Tour guides do that.
It's party day.
Mr. D. Monday at 8 on CBC.
This week on the Mercer Report, training with Olympic swimmers in Victoria, BC.
An all-new Rick Mercer Report, Tuesday at 8 on CBC.
I'm feeling like bait!
Welcome back to the show that is changing the way we look at smarts. Tonight, we are facing spectacular challenges of 6 different kinds of intelligence to determine Canada's smartest person. Our 4 finalists are just getting started. We're still in the category of linguistic smarts, and to help us with our next challenge is actor, comedian, musician, and writer, Mr. Sean Cullen. Hey, Sean.
Hi. Hi, world. Hello, Jerry.
Are you up for this?
I'm very excited. I like to extemporize myself, and I can't wait to see how people handle this challenge.
Yeah, I don't know what extemporize means, but we'll see what that is. This is called Spin a Speech, and here's how it works. Our 4 participants are currently sequestered backstage. One at a time, they will come on stage and spin the speech wheel to select a topic and give the best speech they can in 45 seconds. To earn points, they have to incorporate as many words as they can from the following list. Tom, elixir, joyous, crystallized, driven, alone, evergreen, acquiesce, recreation, sausages, whimsy, cornea, sorrel, holiday, demure, Labrador, sumptuous, flying, yellow, beaver, special mistress, whiskey, townhouse, shotgun, loquacious, angel, triangle, politics, and spectrum. Just like that. Participants will also be judged for the quality of their speech by our guest expert, Sean. Once again, a maximum of 5 points are up for grabs for first place. Sean, are you ready to hear the first speech?
I can't wait.
All right, Sean can't wait, I can't wait. Let's bring out Greg. Come on out, Greg. Spin a speech. All right. How are you?
You know, I'm doing okay.
It's only one challenge so far.
Yeah, just setting it aside.
Yeah, put it aside. This is your chance to get 5 points back. Spin the wheel, let's see what topic you get. A toast.
A toast?
A toast to the bride.
A toast to the bride.
You are up. You come on up here with me.
Okay.
Here are your 30 words.
Okay.
45 seconds on the clock.
A toast to the bride.
Here you go.
Okay.
Go.
So as I flew in from Labrador across this beaver-infested nation with bleary corneas that allowed me to acquiesce to my sleepiness alone in my hotel room, I spoke to Tom before I came out to see you. You're so beautiful in your wonderful spectrum of colors. the politics of giving this wonderful toast, I can't really tell you, but I feel very special in this moment. I hope that your mistress doesn't have anything to say about what's about to happen. It's a beautiful holiday, a wedding ceremony. You look like an angel. And I know that my speech may be lacking in the type of loquaciousness that may have been possible. So let's lift this elixir, all of us, to the bride and give her
time.
A warm applause.
Very good. What? Very good. Wow.
I thought that was good.
Thank you.
I thought that was good. That's hard to do. But let's hear what the expert says.
You sound like a lovely man to have at a wedding. You make people feel good about living in a beaver-infested land. And I'm worried about the mistress. I want to know about this wedding now. That was a very coherent and interesting speech.
Good job. You can head backstage, Greg.
Great. Thanks.
All right. Let's bring out our next participant. Laura, come on out here. Spin a speech.
All right.
So how are you feeling?
A bit nervous.
Yeah?
I've never done this before, of course.
Okay, let's see what you get.
Okay.
You got a toast to the groom or bride, you got a eulogy up there, you got a valedictorian speech, a breakup. I think we got the breakup. Okay. This is your breakup speech to your partner. All right, come on up here.
Can I make up a name?
If it's real, it's even better for us if it's real.
Like, I'm sorry, I'm gonna break up with you on air.
You're doing it right now. This is a real breakup. This should be easy.
Okay.
Here are your words. Let's put 45 seconds on the clock and go.
Tom, I'm really, really sorry, but I have to end this with you right now. I feel more alone when I'm with you than when I'm actually by myself. I remember our first date, I felt like I was flying. It was like in the Evergreen something park, and we had whiskey for some reason, and that was really messed up and terrible, but I kind of stuck with you. You know, it all just went so fast. It was like shotgun. It was almost like a shotgun wedding sort of thing. I was fearing a shotgun wedding that was gonna show up any second. I felt so special when I was with you, but you know, it's just how the politics sort of play out, I guess.
Fine.
I don't know. Oops.
Come on up. I got a feeling you're still with this guy, because I don't think we really
so
got the message
awkward.
There. It's hard.
Yeah.
It sounds like you shot him, but let's see what shot that.
Yeah.
I'd like to go on a date with you in Evergreen Forest, well, drinking whiskey.
Yeah.
And, but I don't know. I don't think Tom really got a good idea of why you were breaking up with him.
Oh.
Sorry.
Thank you, Laura.
Thanks.
Good job. Up next, Peter, come on out, spin a speech. All right, first place, you're in first place.
All right.
You're in first place.
Keep it up,
don't break the wheel either. I know you're a big, strong guy. You're gonna spin this wheel and pick a topic. Let's see what you get. Oh, a very
nice
sexy
gentle,
spin,
you know?
A very sexy spin. I don't know why, but that was sexy. All right, looks like valedictorian. Your valedictorian speech.
All right.
Were you the valedictorian?
Far from it.
Come on up. Here are your 30 words. Okay, 45 seconds on the clock. Go.
I stand before my classmates today, selected to represent all of you here in our little school in Happy Valley, Goose Bay, Labrador. And it's with a sense of whimsy alone up here on stage that I acquiesce to the will of all the students who voted for me to come out and tell you about the time that we spent together in this school. I know down the road when I'm in my future in politics, living in a great yellow townhouse, going on holiday for recreation in all sorts of amazing places, flying to different destinations, eating exotic sausages. I remember all of you and the demure way, the loquacious manner that we related with each other, and just look at you through my very cornea and have a drink of whiskey in your honor. And just remember the great times that we've had here together. It has been the elixir of my life, a very joyous time, the evergreen of my Christmas tree. Thank you all.
Time! Sean?
I think you should go into politics because you said almost nothing, but it was very, Very entertaining. Thank you very much, Peter.
All right, Peter, backstage over All here, right. please. Good job. All right, our final participant, Marshall. Come on out, Marshall. Spin a speech. So you did well in the first challenge. You're right up there.
Okay.
And this time, we're going to put you to the test with a speech. Spin the wheel. Let's see what topic you get. A breakup. You're married. You're married.
So but let's, not forever.
Let's pretend. Let's pretend that you got to break up with her. Come on up here.
Okay.
Here's the 30 words. 45 seconds on the clock. Go.
When I was in high school, I had to break up with my girlfriend. She was always making me sausages, but I didn't like them. I would rather have fried beaver or an elixir of rum or just to make out under the evergreen tree. That was fun. She had to have a shot of whiskey if she would ever do that with me. We once popped into her grandparents' townhouse. She wouldn't go in at first, but I had a shotgun, so it was okay after. She was a real angel. It was sorrow when we had to break up, but it sort of crystallized my drive for the future. I was driven to find a new girl. It would be a joyous occasion. I wouldn't acquiesce to just anyone. I had to make sure she knew lots about politics.
Thank you, time. That was good. That was good. That was good. Sean?
Marshall, that was a beautiful speech and an interesting reminiscence.
Thank you.
Although I think you were supposed to break up with someone right in front of you. Maybe I'm crazy, but I loved it.
Well,
I did like it. It was interesting. Shotgun in a townhouse.
There you go. All right. Good job, Marshall. Let's bring the other contestants back out. Peter, Laura, Greg, and Marshall. Spin a speech. Great job all around. Not easy to do. Not easy to do. Now, for each word you used, you will get a point. But there's also an additional maximum of 10 points based on the quality of your speech, which is up to Sean. Sean, what are the results?
All right, starting with Greg, you gave a toast to the bride. It was engaging, it was fun. I think the bride was not offended in any way, although the mention of her mistress or his mistress, I don't know whose mistress it was. It was kind of fun. I liked it, it was very coherent. You got 13 words, so that gives you 13 points. I'm gonna give you 8 points for your speech. So that's 21 points.
Hey, Greg.
Ouch.
Laura.
Hi.
Hi there. It's nice to see you. There was a breakup.
Mm-hmm.
And you remembered some great moments, like the evergreen forest and the whiskey drinking.
Yeah,
when you first met.
Yeah.
You used a total of 8 words. Mm-hmm. But I think you were a little hesitant. I think you had a little trouble with this challenge. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give you 5 points for your speech. So altogether, 13. 13 points.
Peter.
Peter, you will one day be the greatest man in the world if it comes to talking nonsense to people. So, you used 18 words out of 30.
Wow.
That's almost a word every 2 seconds. I was amazed, and you kept a coherent flow all the way through your speech. I think we accepted you as the valedictorian, although you had a strange school.
It was a speech I always wanted to give.
I understand. And you gave it with authority. 18 words. I'm going to give you the full 10 points because I think that was a very smooth speech. So all together, 28 points.
28. Marshall.
Marshall, you got 13 words, which is 13 points. It's a nice place to start. Now, I'm not sure if you're off topic or not. I think you're supposed to break up with someone, but you talked about someone you'd broken up with, and I'm willing to accept that. And you were gentle about it. And you had great reminiscences, like the time you went into her parents' townhouse with a shotgun. 13 words. I'm going to give you 7 points for Judge. And so that's 20 points altogether. So the winner of this challenge, I believe, Peter with 28 points.
All right. And based on your placement, let's see the number of points you'll take with you from this challenge.
Peter, 5 points. Marshall, 2. Greg, 3. And Laura, no points in this challenge. Let's hear once again for Sean Collins.
Thank you, everybody. Good luck.
We have now completed the first of 6 intelligences. Let's take a look at your score banners. Peter, you're in first. Massive 5-piece. Word mix, first place. Spin of speech, first place. Perfect. Marshall, you're nipping at his heels. And Greg and Laura, at the end of linguistic smarts, you're behind with 3 points, and you need to catch up in the other intelligence categories. There are 5 intelligences remaining to show us your smarts. We're on our way to finding Canada's smartest person.
I think she was a little nervous. I expected her to do better in the first category, but she actually did surprisingly well with the
Surprisingly
fashion.
Well.
Okay, oh, yeah.
Coming up, you'll have to see it to believe it. Someone get the tea. Marshall, you just make your own letter, that's fine. 30 seconds, people.
Visual intelligence is next, and you get to play along. Go to cbc.ca/smartestperson or download the Canada's Smartest Person app.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Cadbury Cream Eggs. They're here, but only until Easter.
Monday, one company gets shaken up.
There's something going on between these two.
The other faces deep cuts.
You have products that don't make sense to me. It's got to be dealt with.
Brought to you in part by Ally. The Big Decision, Monday at 9 on CBC.
New Ritz Munchables. 50% pretzel, 50% cracker, 110% delicious. It's the Ritz you love with a pretzel crunch. Available in 2 flavors.
Thanks for the second opinion. To think how much I would have missed.
Bring in last year's tax return for a free second look. Our tax pros find money others may have missed. We make taxes painless. H&R Block. Basic returns now $59.99.
My dentist told me what I was eating might be softening the enamel on my teeth. I always have fruit at my desk. I'll crack open an orange. I do enjoy a glass of wine. I wasn't aware that what I was eating was maybe causing me some problems with my teeth, so I was happy to hear that there was something I could do. She recommended Pronamel. It helps to reharden the enamel that's been softened. I use Pronamel as my regular everyday toothpaste. I love smiling. I love showing off my teeth that I've taken care of all my life.
Want to leave your mark? Show us what you can do, and you could win a trip to Ottawa, $5,000 in cash, national fame, and much more. Express your vision. Here is Canada.ca.
Selena Tremblay.
Hey, hon, it's me.
Hi, honey.
How's work?
Same old.
Maybe it's time for that change.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
Life is better when you're prepared. Ask your advisor how Manulife can help you reach your goals.
Winners presents Champions of Spring Fashion. Being a fashion champion isn't just about looking sensational, which you do. It's about getting real brands for a really great price. It's about seeing the same designer outfit in a boutique and knowing you paid a fraction of the price. It's about the look on your girlfriend's faces when they say, "You got that for what?" All while having the decency not to gloat much. Because when you shop to win. Winners, find fabulous for less.
Yeast infection? No problem. Use Kness Oral Combi Pack for a complete system. One oral pill I can take anytime. And cream for fast relief of external irritation. A yeast infection won't hold me back. Kness Oral is the only oral treatment available in a convenient combi pack. Clinically proven. One oral pill to treat internally, plus cream to soothe externally. Say I can with Kness Oral Combi Pack.
Wednesday on an all-new Dragon's Den.
Oh, my God.
Mixing it up in the den.
I'm going to give you a license to drink all you want.
Has things spinning out of control.
Brad, you get around.
Thank you.
An all-new Dragon's Den, brought to you in part by Rogers. Wednesday at 8 on CBC. Wednesday, trouble hits close to home.
Dez's father has been kidnapped.
Don't worry, I'm right upon this.
Really, really close to home.
Are you okay?
He punched you right through the legs.
An all-new Republic of Doyle, Wednesday at 9 on CBC.
Welcome back to the show that will introduce you to Canada's smartest person. All aspects of intelligence are being tested tonight. Up next, it's visual intelligence. Whether you're a pilot landing a plane or you're trying to put together some of that crazy Swedish furniture, it all requires strong visual smarts. Let's check in with Matt and Naomi.
Well, some people are way more intelligent in some areas than others.
Okay, here we go.
Like spatial intelligence. That's sort of my bag.
Right.
Oh. Look, I'm telling you, it's definitely a right at the garbage can.
No, wait, it's a left because there's the pylon and there's the guy going up the stairs.
That's a chair. I'm telling you, we're definitely on the wrong floor. Found it. Okay, so we both have spatial intelligence.
Yeah, high five, buddy.
Wow, I missed that.
Come on, really, huh? Oh!
Our first challenge for visual intelligence is called Spaced Out. Here's how it works. You at home can play along too, so click or tap on the Spaced Out icon right now. This is a classic test of spatial intelligence. You will be given two shapes, a 7 and a T. Your job is to fit 4 segments exactly into the outline of these shapes as fast as you can. Finish the 7 first and then move on to the T. Fastest time wins, and once again, the person who comes first will get 5 points. You can head over your stations now. Are you ready to play at home? We're about to start. Watch for the countdown on the corner of your screen, and when you see the go prompt, press go. Let's put 2 minutes and 30 seconds on the clock. The challenge will begin in 3, 2, 1, go. Make sure it's lined up. Make sure it's lined up when you think you have it. Pick that up, put it on, Peter.
Is that good?
That's good, yeah. Come on. Everyone has the 7 but Marshall. Players at home, how are you doing at this challenge? Did you get the 7 yet? 3 people with 7. Marshall's still stuck on the 7. Still a chance though, Marshall. Looks like the winner's gonna be the one that gets that T first. You all finished the 7 at pretty close times. We'll see how that comes out if no one gets the T. Peter, you just try to hang on to the pieces. That's a good start.
Where'd it go?
Yeah, okay. Peter wins this. This makes no sense. Thank God you're not a running back dropping the ball all the time. Just over a minute left, so plenty of time. Keep focused. Wow. Okay, good, Marshall. That's great. Way to go. Marshall's celebrating. He's in last place. I don't know why he's celebrating. Okay, Marshall. Yeah, just put him on top one. Sure. Someone's got to get the tea. I got the tea, for crying out loud. Come on. Marshall, you just make your own letter. That's fine. You just come up with a new, some Gaelic or something. That's good. You have 30 seconds, people. Someone get the tea. Someone get the tea. Make sure it's lined up. Make sure it's lined up when you think you have it. 15 seconds. Pick that up. Put it on, Peter. 5 seconds. 3, 1, step away. We've got it. We've got it. person to get both. Come on over here. Come on over here. We're gonna take a look at your results. You got it right on time.
Just on the buzzer.
Awesome. So, Greg, you are top of the class for this challenge. Greg is the winner of this challenge. So, based on your placement, let's see the number of points you'll take from this challenge. There you go, Greg in first with 5, Laura and Peter 3, and Marshall 0. And what were your scores like at home? If you're not doing well, don't worry, because there's a lot more chance to play.
I feel great. I really needed to win a challenge, so I'm really excited about that. I feel like I'm back in the game, and it's on from here on in.
Oh, wow, this is awesome.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Mom.
Coming up, Canada's smartest person gets sexy.
I think it looks ravishing.
You look ravishing. It's our second challenge of visual smarts. Time! Right after this.
Flight delays spread anger across the country. Why there's so much at stake in the fight for Jack Layton's seat. Plus, the Ottawa singer who could be the next Celine Dion. Tonight on The National.
How low can America go?
Our friends used to be like England. Now our best friend is Afghanistan, like a bust-out junkie.
John Oliver and guests plumb the depths.
Gay marriage? That's an issue? My house is worth $8.
Just for laughs. Tuesday at 9 on CBC Television.
Pass it off as another day. Just another sun across the sky. But that's what makes it all worthwhile. As quick as it's here, as quick as it goes, as quick as
enjoy every single moment. Craft Singles.
We bought this little paradise all on our own. Why would we need a realtor? We love it here, right, hon?
Actually,
that's just the 11-car train!
I sold our old place and did the paperwork myself. Only one lawsuit.
Termites. Great.
Hey, neighbor!
Punjabi hockey lovers, we're back. Now you can watch CBC's Hockey Night in Canada in your language, thanks to Chevrolet Canada. Catch all the action and the commentary in Punjabi. Go online for details.
Introducing Kleenex Cool Touch Tissues. The only tissue that actively releases a cool sensation to soothe the nose on contact. Kleenex Cool Touch Tissues, a cool new way to soothe.
Managing diabetes can be simplified with the innovative Bayer Contour USB. Easy-to-use features give you access to detailed information so you can track your trends. The Contour USB is part of the Contour family of meters, including the number one pharmacist-recommended Contour meter.
Astro Original All-Natural Plain Yogurt is made with just 3 ingredients. Milk, cream, and cultures. And with no additives, preservatives, or artificial flavors, it tastes like it came straight from nature. Astro Original All-Natural Plain Yogurt. Naturally good, naturally delicious.
Introducing the new Aero Lamb. A delicious new way to experience the joy of Aero. But only until Easter.
Some days, getting kids to start the day with a nutritious breakfast can be a real challenge. That's why there's Carnation Breakfast Essentials. It's a great way to give them wholesome nutrition to help them be their best. Carnation Breakfast Essentials, good nutrition from the start.
If you suffer from joint and arthritis pain, you know that rusty feeling. But do you know that just one Aleve liquid gel has the strength to relieve joint and arthritis pain for up to 12 hours? So you can keep doing what you love. New, fast-acting 12-hour Aleve liquid gels.
4 courses? Are you crazy?
A dinner party or recipe for disaster.
We begin.
Better have a scotch.
They're Muslim.
Well, I guess make it a double.
Hello.
Little Mosque on the Prairie, Monday at 8:30 on CBC.
Welcome back to a very special 2-hour event, Canada's Smartest Person. Tonight, we have assembled 4 Canadians who are trying to prove they can excel in every kind of intelligence.
I think my strongest intelligence, because I am a teacher, is interpersonal. I have to work in groups, I have to work with other people, and I enjoy working with other people.
I think I'm gonna do well in the physical intelligence challenges. If I don't, it's gonna be really, really embarrassing. My whole job is to be physically intelligent.
It's kind of a toss-up between social, musical, and linguistic. Obviously, I'm a spoken word artist, but I'm also very musical, so I like to, you know, like beatbox and sing and rap.
I did spend most of my childhood drawing and sketching, and so art came naturally to me. It wasn't math and science that came naturally to me. I think I can take them down any day.
My weakest intelligence, oh, it's clearly gonna be the math stuff, you know?
Spatial skills, I may be a little rusty on. I'm lucky if I can pack a suitcase to get here. I could hardly put that luggage tag on the baggage. Well, yeah, it's just a pull here. I have to have the person come and do it for me. I thought it was gonna end up in flimflon.
Probably say my weakest intelligence would maybe be the musical intelligence.
My oldest sister took all the musical talent of the family.
She tried to teach me. She got really, really frustrated, and she kind of was like, I quit.
I couldn't get out of the van the other day. The door didn't close right. So this spatial stuff is gonna be interesting.
Everyone I know is always asking me to whistle for them, especially my teammates. There you go. So maybe I've got a little bit of musical talent in annoying people.
We're still in the category of visual smarts. Our next challenge is called Double Take, and it involves models. Here's how it works. Each of you will be paired with a model who is wearing 12 unique items of clothes and accessories. Your models will pose in front of you, do a catwalk, and then leave the stage. But keep your eyes peeled, because the next time you see your models, they will have removed their clothes. And you will have to redress them exactly as they were. Let's start the music and bring out the models. All right, thank you, ladies. You can head backstage. Marshall, I saw you mouth, oh my God.
Yeah.
Right now, you've got a million accessories in your head, so I don't want to disrupt that. Can we please get the ladies back out here? Participants is to redress the model, and to make this a little more difficult, these racks have the 12 items they were wearing plus 24 additional items that will totally confuse you. You will get 1 point for each correct item. Let's put 1 minute on the clock. Are you ready? Go.
And I'd like you to put on this necklace.
There's your skirt.
Put those on.
Marshall, you're going through that like you're gonna buy something. Quicker.
In your other hand? Mm-hmm. You want these?
That dress on?
Yeah. Put these baubles on, yeah. One here.
Hurry up! Who needs pants?
Yeah, yeah.
You don't need pants.
Wear pearl earrings.
Sunglasses go in the same hand. Oh.
Come on. Okay, yeah. Do it.
Sorry. Glasses and purse.
Hurry up.
These boots, please.
Oh, wow. We got one dress fully here. Hurry up. Almost time.
Do it.
Stop. Doesn't count. Okay. Step away from your model, please. Step away. All right, Marshall, how do you think this looks? Is this?
I think it looks ravishing.
Well, we know that. You look ravishing.
Oh, thanks.
What was your system? I mean, you had a little bit of time to.
Well, I used my fingers to try and remember where the accessories were, but didn't even know she was wearing a belt.
Didn't know she was wearing a belt. Well, you can't get every item. I think this is, from what I remember, this looks pretty.
But it's missing like two items and I can't figure it out and I'm all hot and bothered now that
I
can't.
You wanna start again?
Yeah, I would like to, you know.
Perfectionist. Greg, how do you think you did?
I did all right. I know a couple things for sure are wrong. But I think I got most of it.
All right, I think we're all curious to see how you guys did. We have your results. How did the four of you do at double take?
All right.
Laura, last place Laura. That's what we've been calling you backstage. I'm just kidding. Laura, that's big for you. That gets a high five. Good.
All right.
Okay, Laura's got 11 points from this. Let's see how many points you take with you from this challenge. Laura, 5 points, which you needed. Everyone join me over here and let's take a look at your banners after two intelligences. Peter, first place, 16, filling up nicely. Laura, the big win in the visual intelligence, has got you with 11 points. You jump into second place.
All right.
From last to second very quickly.
Nice.
Marshall and Greg tied for third or tied for last. We could say it either way.
Third's good.
But the bottom line is right now, you two would not be in the final unless you get into that top two spots. So you've got some things to work on, but the profiles are filling up and the competition is heating up. Two intelligences down and four more to come.
Got some great support in the crowd. I got the prettiest girl in Ontario right here with me.
When the models walked out, I thought, I totally know what they're wearing. Peter, it's not his strong suit. He never knows what I'm wearing, and he also can't tell girls apart, ever. He thinks we all look the exact same.
3, 2, 1, go. Coming up, are you a human calculator?
Not good.
Get ready to play along with our participants when they take on logical intelligence. Peter's in a rhythm. Peter's in a rhythm.
Next on Canada's Smartest Person.
All new Monday.
Love field trips.
Let's get on the bus.
8 hours spare today.
There's a few things you have to do.
They have to learn.
Take care of the kids.
Tour guides do that.
It's party day.
Mr. D, Monday at 8 on CBC.
It's easy to start something good with Lipton Green Tea. We hand-select the best leaves, steam or pan-fire them to bring out their fresh taste and aroma in a way that's certified to respect the environment and local growers. So your green tea isn't only full of flavor, it's full of goodness. Lipton Green Tea. Try our delicious superfruit flavors.
Canadians have no problem being out in the cold. No self-respecting Canadian says, let's wait for a warmer day. Here, braving the cold is a national sport. You and your clothes embrace cold weather. Why not wash them in cold water? Tide does better at getting stains out in cold water than the other guy. And washing in cold can save you 70% of the energy in each load. Cold Canadian temperatures? Bring them on. Tide.
Amy Sedaris here, laundry expert, and I'm here to shake up your fresh with new Downy Unstoppables. First, pour these feisty little scent boosters into the cap. Use a little or a lot. Throw them straight into the washer before you start the wash. And then they go to work infusing your whole wash with scents that just won't quit. Won't quit. And they work in any washer. Top load, side load, your neighbor's washing machine. So, pick your favorite fresh scent and enjoy it till you wash again. It's unstoppable. And you're unstinkable.
A yeast infection won't hold me back. With Kness Oral Combi Pack, a complete system. One oral pill I can take anytime. And cream for fast relief of external irritation. Kness Oral, the only oral treatment in a convenient combi pack. Say I can with Kness Oral.
Hey.
If only everything came with Glad Odor Guard. Glad Kitchen Catcher garbage bags with Odor Guard help stop garbage smells in your home. Available on a variety of Glad garbage and recycling products.
Delicio has a golden brown delivery style crust and amazing delivery style toppings. All we're missing is a delivery style guarantee. Because if we made you wait 30 minutes, your Delicio wouldn't be free. It would just be burnt. Delicio Rising Crust Pizza. It's not delivery, it's Delicio. Delicio Rising Crust Pizza has amazing toppings and a fresh baked crust. But does it really compare to delivery? Sure, if you put it in the trunk of a rusted out hatchback and drive around the block until it gets cold. Delicio Rising Crust Pizza. It's not delivery, it's Delicio.
Then you know that's 40% less fat.
Cheers, cheers.
Have you ever had a lasagna that tastes this good that's actually good for you?
Delicious.
Over 400 ways to eat well with Blue Menu. There's your smoothie. And what has it got in it that's good?
Omega-3.
Is it easier to rock climb or make healthier choices?
Make healthier choices.
And you look at that little arrow, and that'll tell you whether it's got less salt or even high fiber. First one up gets the last smoothie.
Oh! President's Choice, worth switching supermarkets for.
Monday, one company gets shaken up.
There's something going on between these two.
The other faces deep cuts.
You have products that don't make sense to me. It's got to be dealt with.
Brought to you in part by Ally. The Big Decision, Monday at 9 on CBC.
This week on the Mercer Report, training with Olympic swimmers in Victoria, BC.
An all-new Rick Mercer Report, Tuesday at 8 on CBC.
I feel like bait!
To the show that is redefining what it means to be smart. This is Canada's Smartest Person. And for everyone at home, it's not too late. You can play along too. If you haven't already done so, just go to cbc.ca/smartestperson or download the Canada Smartest Person app on the App Store. Tonight, we are challenging all our participants with 6 different ways to measure intelligence. What's up next? Logical intelligence. This is about way more than just math. Let's see what our expert has to say about it.
People with strong logical intelligence are good at recognizing patterns and solving abstract problems. They could be a scientist, computer programmer, or accountant. Canadians like David Suzuki or Alexander Graham Bell are examples of strong logical thinkers. Let's see how this intelligence works in the real world.
Matt and I are planning a vacation to Aruba.
It's gonna be great, mm-hmm. And I've got a savings plan all laid out.
Yeah, saving is fun.
It's a 48-day equation. If we cut out all non-essentials like car use, clothing purchases, and dining out, we should be good to go.
Yeah, I have a different total to that equation.
The key is to have a system. We have a change jar, a swear jar, and I used to have a jar for credit cards, but I seem to have misplaced it.
I must have messed up the calculations because we're like $50 short.
Okay, fine. I bought him an anniversary present.
Anniversary present. Oh,
our next challenge is called Human Calculator. Here's how it works. We'll play 3 rounds, with each round increasing in difficulty. Each round will consist of 8 math questions, and you'll have just 5 seconds to answer each one. This is a challenge you can play along with at home. Click or tap Human Calculator right now. Watch for the countdown on the corner of your screen, and when you see the go prompt, press go and play along. Please put 40 seconds on the clock for round 1. Round 1 of Human Calculator will begin in 3, 2, 1, go. All right, round 1. Let's see the answers from that round. Let's see how everybody did. Okay. All right, Peter, wow. The athlete, the football player, the mathematician.
They must be tracking someone else's iPad.
7 points for Peter. Are you ready for round 2? Let's put 40 seconds on the clock. At home, watch for the go prompt. We begin in 3, 2, 1, go. Thank you. All right. Let's see the answers from that round. A little harder?
A little bit.
Not my strong
suit,
man.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna put up your cumulative score. Marshall 12, Laura 9, Greg 6. You're playing along at home. Again, watch for the go prompt. Human calculator, final round starts in 3, 2, 1, go. All right, now, what were the answers for the final round? Shaking your head, Greg.
Not good.
No chance?
Not good.
Let's see how you did. Oh! Peter, you hung on. You pulled away. Peter, you got 18 correct answers out of a possible 24. That is really good. Let's see after this round what scores you're gonna take with you on the complete profile. Peter. 5 points for Peter, 3 for Marshall, 2 for Laura and Greg. You are sliding, but you are never out. All right, we're still in the category of logical intelligence. Let's turn around. Our next challenge is called Logic Towers. Once again, first place will get you 5 points. Please take your place beside your set of towers. Here's how it works. It's a race to move all the blocks from tower 1 to tower 3. You can only move one piece at a time to any of the towers, but here's the catch. You can never put a larger piece on top of a smaller piece. Participants, are you ready for a mind twister? Let's put 2 minutes on the clock in 3, 2, 1, go. Peter, Outstanding. This is big.
Peter is amazing.
Laura, you were right behind him.
This guy's the Incredible Hulk here. These blocks are heavy.
They're heavy, but...
So he's just like, yeah, whatever.
But you were second.
Yeah,
and you needed to come second? You need to stay in this?
Strategy.
Greg, it's tough, right? It's something that if you don't grab it and you're not following the pattern, it wasn't coming to you.
No.
You look down. What's going on in your head right now?
I got a lot of ground to make up.
A lot of ground.
Not enough time.
Not a lot of time. There's enough time. There's enough challenges. But you can't have results like this again.
You think?
I know. You can go from last to first.
I could.
Worst to first.
You know?
Marshall!
Could I do it with two blocks?
I think you could do it with two blocks.
Two blocks?
Does that make you feel good?
That would make me feel good.
Same boat for you. What's going on? It was just something wasn't coming to you?
I kept repeating the same pattern. Then I thought, I know what I'm going to do, and I kept repeating the same mistake. So it happens sometimes.
Even for a smart PhD science person.
It can happen.
It can happen. Just to show you that this show is about multiple intelligence, and that's exactly what we're seeing right here. So based on your placement, let's see the number of points you'll take from this challenge. Peter, first place. Laura, 3 points in second. Marshall and Greg, you don't get any points because you did not complete the challenge. All right, that does it for Logical Smarts. We've now completed 3 out of our 6 intelligences, and Canada's smartest person is starting to come into focus. Let's take a look at your score banners. Wow, Peter. Peter, you won both challenges in Logical. You have a total of 26 points. There's almost no mistakes. Marshall, little bits and pieces there. You're still within range. Greg, same thing. Laura, you are getting closer, but you're still in there. And the focus right now has got to be to get to the final 2 so you can compete in our final multiple intelligence challenge. We are halfway there to finding out who Canada's smartest person is going to be. It doesn't get any easier, Canada. The pressure is on.
I'm fired up, and that was a good workout. I'm apt, pulse is, 180 through the roof, which is good because I missed my workout today.
Marshall, how are you doing?
Good.
Lars was an usher at my wedding.
Usher at the wedding.
But we're very close friends.
Good friends since grade 7.
What did you think?
We were all very proud of you.
I had a big rooting section, didn't I?
You had a great rooting section. Yeah. The crowd was with you. They realized who everybody feels is the smartest Canadian.
Ah, shucks.
Coming up, a dragon enters our den to guest judge our fabulous 4's social intelligence.
Language is the most important and the most impressive creation.
It's an invention.
And don't forget, you can test your people skills at cbc.ca/smartestperson when Canada's smartest person returns.
Help wanted. Young Canadians are finding very few job opportunities, let alone career paths, opening up before them. CBC News Marissa Draghetti looks at just how difficult it is for 18 to 24-year-olds tonight on The National.
Kraft Hockeyville 2012. We're down to the top 5 communities. It's time, Canada, to pick a winner. Vote online and on your mobile device at crafthockeyville.ca or call toll-free. This year's winner will be announced on CBC's Hockey Night in Canada, March 31st, and get $100,000 in arena upgrades from Kraft, an NHL preseason game, and a visit from CBC's Hockey Night in Canada. Vote for your favorite community today. Brought to you in part by the Oriole 100th anniversary.
The subtle details you appreciate when your senses tune in as the world tunes out. Cabin quiet tuning. IntelliLink connected radio. Unrivaled interior detail. Welcome to the new compact luxury. The 2012 Buick Verano. Buick, inspire your senses.
At this price, I could get a whole bevy of bunnies.
Actually, you would never refer to a group of bunnies as a bevy. A group of swans is a bevy. For bunnies, you could say a warren or a nest. Perhaps even a herd. But those would have to be domesticated bunnies.
So how many should we get?
A herd.
Share Easter baskets of fun with everyone. It's Walmart.
Selena Tremblay.
Hey, hon, it's me.
Hi, honey.
How's work?
Oh, same old.
Maybe it's time for that change.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
Life is better when you're prepared. Ask your advisor how Manulife can help you reach your goals.
What makes a happy mom? A happy baby. And a happy feeding. So, if introducing infant formula, start happy and see why no other formula is like Good Start Probiotic. Talk to your doctor and visit goodstart-difference.ca.
How's the run?
Imagine if you could see the plastic water bottles Canadians bought last year. 300 standard 500 milliliter plastic bottles can effectively be replaced by one Brita filter.
It's good, thanks.
Brita, filter for good. Now you can enjoy great tasting tap water from any faucet, anywhere. Introducing the Brita bottle with the filter inside.
Wednesday on an all-new Dragon's Den.
Oh, my God.
Mixing it up in the den.
I'm going to give you a license to drink all you want.
Has things spinning out of control.
Brad, you get around.
Thank you.
An all-new Dragon's Den. Brought to you in part by Rogers. Wednesday at 8 on CBC.
Welcome back. Tonight we will meet Canada's smartest person. He or she will demonstrate strength in six different areas of intelligence. The next intelligence we are looking at is social. If you're a good leader, persuasive, and you can pick up on social cues, this might be your strong suit. Let's take a look at social intelligence.
The gas went out the other day, something to do with the pilot light. I don't know. No furnace.
Brutal.
So Naomi used her interpersonal skills to sort it all out.
You're welcome.
She just put me on hold again.
Stay calm.
Yeah, I am calm. Yes, you can help me, mother. You for everything.
Hi, so sorry.
What the?
Well, how could she know that about your mother, really? Can we start over?
Yours is no.
So where are you calling from? I heard it's nice there. Yes. I appreciate it.
Yo!
Good news. We're going to Aruba. Yay!
Yay! All right, from this point on, there's only one challenge per intelligence, and each challenge is now worth double the points. First place will get you 10 points, second 6, third 4, and still a goose egg for last place. Our next challenge is called Power of Persuasion. And in order to win this one, you'll have to persuade our special guest judge that you truly are Canada's smartest person. Helping us out for this one is the author of the best-selling book Persuasion from the hit CBC series Dragon's Den. Please welcome Arlene Dickinson. Arlene, you get pitched ideas every week on Dragon's Den. How are some people more persuasive than others?
Persuasion to me has three pillars, right? One is that you have to be really honest about what you're saying. Number two is that you have to be really authentic and genuine about who you are. And number three is you have to believe in a win-win. But then it's also about body language and are you looking me in the eye and do you really believe what you're saying to me? And can I be persuaded by your argument about why I should go along with you and believe that you're the best?
And now we will see who does it the best. For 10 points at this stage in the game, that's huge. You will have to persuade Arlene that you are Canada's smartest person. You will be given 30 seconds to make an opening statement, and then you will have to answer and debate questions. You'll then get 15 seconds to make a closing argument, and after that, Arlene will rank you based on how persuasive you were. And Canada, you can play along with this challenge too. Click or tap on Power of Persuasion now, listen to the debate, and then try to guess Arlene's results. Over to you, Arlene.
Okay, Marshall, we're gonna start with you.
Okay.
Go.
I am Canada's smartest person. Why? I've got visual smarts. I can see right through folks. Social skills, I tell really good jokes. logical deductions like Star Trek's Mr. Spock, musical intelligence, I roll and I rock. I've got physical stamina, I can walk my dog. Verbal masterpieces, I write a really good blog. Now I'm out of time, but thank you very much.
You are out of time, that's all. All right, Peter, you ready?
Yep.
All right, you've got 30 seconds to tell me why you should win. Go.
Sometimes wrong, never indecisive. In my job as a pro football player, I have to make split-second decisions again and again. I've got guys behind me. Their livelihood, their physical well-being depends on me doing it right, doing it fast. And everyone else here, they can talk about the letters behind their names. I can do that too. I got Mensa. I got SAT score broke their computer. But the fact of the matter is, when the rubber hits the road, when you're on the field, you gotta make decisions fast. All that stuff goes out the window. End of the day, you gotta make a decision. Who's Canada's smartest person? Right here, Ty Cats Grey Cup 2012.
Hi.
Hi, Laura. How you doing? So it's your turn to convince me in 30 seconds. You ready?
Sure.
All right, go.
I actually didn't start off really good at math. I started off as more of a visual person. I was very, very artsy. I won a bunch of awards growing up in arts and in story writing, but I trained that up. And I stand here as a testament for you today to show that you can work at all the intelligences, and I'm an atomic physicist today. I build lasers for CERN.
Done. Mm-hmm. All right. Greg, are you ready?
I'm ready to go.
All right, go.
CSP, Canada's smartest person. Why am I that person? Well, it comes down to being able to apply what you've learned throughout the course of your life in real time. So I've had those opportunities to get my education, to work with people in different sorts of environments and situations. But most importantly, what I think it is this upbringing that I had from living in a very, you know, kind of a rougher neighborhood to being able to go to university and conversing with CEOs of companies. I'm comfortable in every possible sort of environment you can put me in.
All right, time. So the next part of the challenge is a little bit different. I'm going to give you a question, and then I'm going to open it up to whoever wants to answer it first, and then you're going to be able to debate and discuss amongst you about why your answer to the question proves to me that you are Canada's smartest person. You guys ready?
Ready.
What is the greatest invention in the history of all time?
Language.
Definitely.
By far, language is the most important and the most impressive creation. Without the foundation of language, we could never have developed
it's
ways.
It's an invention?
Is language an invention? Animals have languages. Animals have languages. Whales have languages. The telegraph, man's first attempt to transmit information by electricity, has led to everything. The internet, television.
Yeah,
it all comes
from
the telegraph.
I completely disagree. I believe it's the internet. No other invention in human history has been able to.
The telegraph.
No. Before there was
every modern communications technology we
have. Marshall, you're not getting a much tamestous talk here. I'm going to give you a little bit of breathing room.
Periodic table is the greatest invention of all time. Complexities of nature are categorized by an invention which is so cheap, 25 cents, you can get your own periodic table and spans all these great things
all
that
right.
these people are talking about.
Why you guys can't make heads or tails of the periodic table? I don't use it in my day-to-day life. The telegraph opened up new worlds to humanity.
You use the telegraph in your day-to-day life?
It's the internet that has revolutionized society.
Humans created language.
Still a question whether that's an invention, but those are awesome answers. You're all very persuasive.
You now have 15 seconds each to make a closing statement and to persuade Arlene that you are Canada's smartest person. Greg, let's start with you. 15 seconds on the clock and begin.
Arlene, I have spent a lot of time and a lot of effort and a lot of energy becoming someone who is a well-rounded individual, who's able to operate in many different areas in many different ways, musically, poetically, logically. I still strongly stand in my belief that I'm Canada's smartest person.
Thank you. Laura, why are you Canada's smartest person?
Okay, so I might not be able to tackle you very well, or might not be able to rhyme you to death with every last breath, but I am Canada's smartest person because I am very, very strong in multiple intelligences, and I deal very, very well with people, and I'm able to have a good time while I do.
Time.
So.
Thank you, Laura. Peter, why are you Canada's smartest person?
I can sit around in a lab all day and come up with amazing
things. You're not telling
me.
You're telling
me. Just like everybody else.
But on the football field, I can make split-second decisions, so I can do all that, and then I can also act quickly, make decisive, meaningful choices that impact other people. And as far as everything else, I love Scrabble, Tetris, you name it, I got it.
Time, thank you. And Marsha, why are you Canada's smartest person?
I have a PhD in theoretical quantum chemistry, but I left research to use multiple intelligences to teach high school students. Aside from marrying my wife, it's the smartest move I ever did.
And Canada, this is your challenge. How do you think Arlene will rank the participants? Lock in your answers now. All right, Arlene, it's over to you.
Okay. So I'm going to just give you guys some comments before I tell you who actually won, because it was a very difficult decision. So I do want to make sure you understand why I chose the winners in the order I did. So, Greg, I thought you were very persuasive in your body language. You made sure that you looked at me, you leaned forward, you engaged me. I thought that was awesome. Off the top, you kind of lost me in terms of what you were saying, because you're so busy in how you were saying it, right? So sometimes what you're saying gets lost because you're trying to be a little bit clever with what you're saying. But you were very persuasive, it was good. Laura, you're very confident about what you're saying, and you come across as very confident, and that always is very persuasive when you're speaking with somebody. Yeah. You also made some very good counterpoints around why they shouldn't win, but not as many points as to why you should. Mm-hmm. Peter, man, you pack a punch. You make sure that you take every second that you've got and devote it to ensuring that you have tons of content. So I give you full marks for content. You lost me a little bit because you were talking a little bit around instead of to me, so some of the body language I struggled with a little bit. But other than that, I thought your points were persuasive and I thought you were very strong as well. Marshall, body language was an issue for me, I have to admit. You kind of lost me, you leaned a little bit, you lost me a little bit in your confidence. I'd say some of your confidence wasn't coming through, but your points were really strong. You were very persuasive in what you were trying to get me to convince me about. And I liked what you said. I thought it was very, very interesting and persuasive as well. All four of you do a really good job in what is an enormously difficult thing. So kudos to all of you. I thought you all did a great job.
So, Arlene, unfortunately now you have to rank them for us.
Yes, this was really hard, but I am going to rank as follows. And it was very close, first and second, I have to say. Marshall, I'm going to give you first. I think.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Greg, you were very, very close second. Oh. You were very good. Peter third, and Laura fourth.
So, based on your placement in this challenge, let's see the number of points you will take with you. Marshall 10, Greg 6, Peter 4, and unfortunately, Laura does not take any with her. Thank you very much, Arlene Dickinson.
Thank you. Good luck to all of you.
Let us see now how everyone is shaping up on the score banners. All right. So, Peter, coming third, kept the gap closer. Marshall, you leapfrogged Laura by coming first in the power of persuasion. Congratulations. And Greg, coming second, brought you right back into things. So it just shows you how these latter challenges, the points being worth more, are going to bring you up quickly. So congratulations, Peter, you are in the lead with Marshall now, not too far behind, but anything can happen in the next intelligence.
Looks like I just have to win all the other competitions. That's just what I'll have to do, you know?
Arlene Dickinson, like one of the most powerful people in the world, and she liked me. She really liked me.
Coming up, a challenge that is music to your ears. Musical intelligence is next. Marshall, did you hear the song?
Not really.
Okay. See how you compare with our participants. Play along at cbc.ca/smartestperson or download the Canada's Smartest Person app.
Monday.
I have an enormous desire to see independent retailers in this country survive. Independent retail is really the backbone of the country, and it's really important.
A Toronto clothing store is hanging by a thread.
Another big surprise. The lights will have to go off.
The other.
an Ottawa chocolate company stretched to the breaking point.
It's clear that, like, there's a problem.
But getting the money won't be easy.
You have products that don't make sense to me, so it's got to be dealt with.
She shakes up one company and pushes it to the brink.
Anne does not take too kindly to having her hands slapped.
There's something going on between these two that doesn't allow them to be completely honest with each other.
While the chocolate company must make deep cuts.
We went out on a limb, and everybody went out there with us.
If they pull it off, Arlene will deliver a big decision.
This is one of the hardest business decisions I think I've ever made.
Save one, save both, or save neither. The Big Decision, Monday at 9 on CBC.
Cheese, for all the stretchers out there, and the diggers, for all the adjusters and mixer-uppers. But why stop there when there are takers, heartbreakers, for the movers and shakers, even the haters? They all come around sooner or later, for all the pilers, and lest we forget all the early morning smilers. All you need is cheese.
We got a real mom in the family car to do an experiment. We put a week of her family's smelly stuff all in at once to prove that new Febreze car vent clips could eliminate the odor. Then we brought her family to our test facility to see if it worked.
Take a deep breath. Tell me what you smell.
Something fresh.
A beach.
A clean house.
My new car.
Go ahead and take your blindfolds off.
Oh.
Look at all this garbage.
Introducing new Febreze car. Eliminates odors for continuous freshness so you can breathe happy.
Accelerate your breath.
Don't let bad breath get in the way. Chewing XL freshens your breath so you can get closer. Accelerate your breath. Also available, XL Mints.
If you suffer from joint and arthritis pain, you know that rusty feeling. But do you know about Aleve? With just one pill, Aleve has the strength to relieve arthritis pain, stiffness, and joint pain for up to 12 hours. So you can keep doing whatever you love to do. Aleve, one pill, 12 hours strength, 12 hours length. And introducing new fast-acting Aleve liquid gels.
I think she likes the sirloin.
The Sirloin Uncle Burger, a taste of burger bliss.
Hey.
If only everything came with Glad Odor Guard. Glad Kitchen Catcher garbage bags with Odor Guard help stop garbage smells in your home. Available on a variety of Glad garbage and recycling products.
Tons of caramel. Of fudge and piles of peanuts, all covered in a chocolatey coating. O. Henry, the colossal combination.
Oh. Four courses? Are you crazy?
A dinner party or recipe for disaster.
We begin. Better have a scotch. They're Muslim. I don't think it's making a double.
Hello.
Little Mosque on the Prairie, Monday at 8:30 on CBC. How low can America go?
Our friends used to be like England.
Now our best friend is Afghanistan, like a bust-out junkie.
John Oliver and guests plumb the depths.
Gay marriage? That's an issue? My house is worth $8.
Just for laughs, Tuesday at 9 on CBC Television.
Welcome back to Canada's Smartest Person, the show that is proving intelligence is about a lot more than just book smarts and trivia. So what's the next intelligence we're testing? Musical. Music is a powerful force in our lives that some people grasp naturally and others, not so much. Let's check in with our intelligence expert.
Musical strength means you have the ability to compose and to understand sound, rhythm, and melody. Famous musicians from Glenn Gould to Michael Bublé are able to inspire us and move us through their music. It's an ability that comes naturally to some, and with quite a bit more practice to others.
Music's a huge part of our lives. Like, it's just in me. I'm feeling it.
Yeah, and she's always singing it, too.
Maddie, what's that song? Yeah? Nothing? That's the chorus part. It's basically our song. It's like... Oh, no, wait. No, I made that up.
Our challenge for musical intelligence is called Lost Instrument. Once again, a maximum of 10 points is up for grabs. Here's how it works. We're gonna play a music track featuring 8 instruments. After that, we'll play it again, but 4 of the instruments will have dropped out. Your challenge will be to determine which instruments dropped out and in what order. Please put on your headphones now. And Canada, are you musical? You can play along with the challenge too. Click or tap on Lost Instrument now. Watch for the countdown on the corner of your screen, and when you see the go prompt, press go. Is everyone ready? Let's start by hearing the 8 instruments in the music. Glockenspiel. Drums. Bass guitar. Electric guitar. Clave. Saxophone. Violin. And piano. It's now time to hear them all together. We're going to hear that tune again. Listen closely. You will have to identify which instruments dropped out and in what order. 3, 2, 1, go. You have 10 seconds to lock in your answers. 10 seconds. Time. Now, for every instrument you identified in the right spot, you will receive 2 points. If you correctly identified the instrument, but it's in the wrong spot, you get 1 point. Marshall, how do you feel about it?
I don't know.
Do you feel you got any?
I think I might have got one.
Laura?
Oh God, I failed that terribly.
All right, let's see which instruments dropped out and what your answers were. The first instrument to drop out was saxophone. Marshall, did you get saxophone?
Yeah, but not in the
But not in that order. Second instrument to drop out, electric guitar. You got that too, Peter. You got the first 2. In order.
Yep.
Third instrument to drop out was the violin. Anybody have that in the third position? Marshall?
I had it, but in the fourth position.
But in the fourth position. And finally, the fourth instrument to drop out was the clave.
Yes.
You got the clave, Laura.
Yep. I heard the clave.
You
actually.
Heard the clave?
I heard the clave last.
Marshall did not. Did you hear the song?
Not really.
Okay. All right, let's see your scores. Peter, 6 points, Laura, 5, Greg, 4. Marshall, you got 2 points, not bad. Let's see how many points you take with you from this challenge. Peter, 10, Laura, 6, Greg, 4. Marshall, no points from this challenge, but we are through 5 intelligences. Let's see how everyone is shaping up on the score banners.
Yes.
Peter with 40 in the lead. Marshall. Marshall with 21. Lauren second, 22. And Greg right behind with 18, which means, Peter, mathematically, you will be in the final two. But the three of you all have a chance to get into that final competition. Any one of you right now could be that person. Things are heating up. We are this close to meeting Canada's smartest person.
So I'm in the middle right now, you know, in the hunt, as they say, for the playoffs. And do I get the Stanley Cup at the end? Stay tuned.
This is the last chance you have. Coming up, is it Greg, Marshall, or Laura? Who will muscle their way through physical intelligence to join Peter in the finale? Find out when Canada's smartest person returns.
Closed captioning is brought to you by the new Brita bottle with a filter inside. Enjoy great tasting tap water anywhere.
Canada's Economic Action Plan is helping create jobs and growth.
I got grants to help pay for my apprenticeship,
but getting this job is where it really paid off.
It's pretty cool work, too.
Thank you.
And I got support to help retrain for a new job. It is great to be back to work.
In a fragile global economy, Canada has a plan focused on jobs and growth. To find out more, visit actionplan.gc.ca. A message from the Government of Canada.
This is penne alla ragù with cipollini and rapini. It's very simple, it's delicious. A little bit of salt. And very important ingredient, Brunello. This Brunello is 2002. A little bit of ground beef. I ground the beef myself. This is veal, Provini veal, and grilled it a little bit, right? Here's the cipollini, the D'Angelo cipollini. They're beautiful. And here's a little bit of D'Angelo rapini. And I parboiled the penne. The penne is al dente. Put a little more salt, a little bit of oregano, or oregano as they call it across the pond, and a drop of balsamic vinegar. This is one of my favorite dishes in the world. Look at this. Penne with rapini and cipollini alla ragù. From zero to great taste. The 1 minute recipe.
D'Angelo Basket Fresh Cipollini in your favorite supermarket.
Baby, let me show you how to do
Hershey's Drops. A lot of Hershey's happiness in smooth and creamy drops of milk chocolate and cookies and cream. Pure happiness.
How's the run?
Imagine if you could see the plastic water bottles Canadians bought last year. 300 standard 500 milliliter plastic bottles can effectively be replaced by one Brita filter.
It's good, thanks.
Brita, filter for good. Now you can enjoy great tasting tap water from any faucet, anywhere. Introducing the Brita bottle with the filter inside.
A yeast infection won't hold me back. With Kness Oral Combi Pack, a complete system. One oral pill I can take anytime. And cream for fast relief of external irritation. Kness Oral, the only oral treatment in a convenient combi pack. Say I can with Kness Oral.
It's the Lens Crafters semi-annual lens event. That's 50% off lenses, including bifocals, no lines, even sunglasses made with your prescription. So hurry in. Sale ends April 1st. Lens Crafters.
Twizzlers, the twist you can't resist.
Monday, one company gets shaken up.
There's something going on between these two.
The other faces deep cuts.
You have products that don't make sense to me. It's got to be dealt with.
Brought to you in part by Ally, The Big Decision, Monday at 9 on CBC. Wednesday, trouble hits close to home.
Dez's father has been kidnapped.
Don't worry, I'm on this.
Really, really close to home.
Are you okay?
He punched you right in the legs.
An all-new Republic of Doyle, Wednesday at 9 on CBC.
Welcome back to Canada's Smartest Person. So far tonight, we have challenged our participants in five different areas of intelligence, and we have one more to go. And things are about to get physical. Physical intelligence is often underestimated, but it shouldn't be. Let's check in with Matt and Naomi.
So it was Naomi's birthday recently, and I really wanted to get her something amazing. Oh. Surprise! I'm gonna learn how to dance!
Wow!
An ethnic thing.
Wait, that's... Wow! You did great!
Yeah?
Go, ow, ow, ow.
No!
Oh! He actually ended up getting me this necklace, so that's sweet.
Happy birthday!
Oh, still sweet.
Our next challenge is the final one tonight. It's called sports stacking, and here's how it works. Well, actually, let me show you how it works. Everyone, please welcome world-class sports stacker, Jackie Huang. Jackie? How are you? Great to meet you. Come in here, Jackie. Tell us how old you are, first of all.
I'm 14 years old.
14, and how long have you been sports stacking?
2 years.
2 years. And is this something you practice?
I practice an hour a day.
And you are one of the best, and we're happy to have you. Come on down here. Jackie Huang, everybody. Now, this is a 363 stack.
Yeah.
And this is the same thing that our finalists are gonna do.
Yeah.
All right, Jackie, show us how it's done.
To do the 363, you stack the 3, 6, and then another 3, and you go back to where you started, and you take it down, take it down, and take it down.
Now we wanna see you do it as fast as you can.
Okay.
All right, well, just for fun, let's see the cycle.
Okay.
That is incredible physical intelligence. Jackie Huang, thank you so much for being with us. We appreciate it. Good luck in your sports stacking. Participants, back to your tables. This is it. Only the two of you with the highest overall scores after this challenge will move on to the final round and will be in the running to be named Canada's Smartest Person. For the other two, it's going to be the end of the line. This is huge. This is it. Everything you've done is coming down to this final challenge. Starting with the cups in the front of you, stack up the 363 formation, and then stack it down. The fastest time will win, and you'll each get 3 chances to go show us what you can do. Everyone place your hands on the timer pad. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Three of you are done. Come on, Marshall. Build a sandcastle. There we go. All right. So, Peter, your score doesn't really matter to us right now because you're already in the finals. But Marshall, Greg, and Laura, yours does. Marshall, Laura, you're going to have to beat Greg.
Mm-hmm.
9.02 right now is the time to beat. If Laura and Marshall, if you don't beat that in your next 2 tries, you're going into the final 2. Are we ready?
Mm-hmm.
Round 2, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. Marshall, your time got better.
Yeah.
But it's still not better than Greg's.
Oh, well.
Greg's first time is still the time to beat. Laura,
mm-hmm.
If you don't beat 9.02,
yeah.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Marshall, you need to pick up something. You need to do something different in your strategy.
I'm going warp speed.
You got to go warp speed. Okay. You got better. but we gotta beat Greg.
Okay.
This is the last chance you have. This is it. The third and final chance. 3, 2, 1, go! Laura's done. 8.18 seconds. Laura is going in. There's our finalist number one. There's our finalist number two. Greg, wow.
So close.
You just got close. You were in there, Marshall. That's the end of the line.
That's okay.
For one last time, let's take a final look at our multiple intelligence profiles. Let's bring them up. There they are. And there's your winner right now, standing in first place, is Peter and Laura. The two of you will go on to compete in our multiple intelligence obstacle course. And congratulations to Greg and Marshall on even being here, even getting this far, being chosen from thousands of Canadians across Canada. Just being in the final four is still an outstanding accomplishment. All right, now we are down to two. Who will be Canada's smartest person? Everything is erased, and it comes down to one final challenge.
I may have some students who saw what I did and said, hey, you know, Dr. Carroll, I want to try this too. And in a few years, I hope they have a chance. And I'll come and be their coach if they want.
I feel a little bit frustrated. There were at least three or four challenges that I missed by this much. And the final challenge with the final cup on my final try when I had a pretty good time going, it's just, it's kind of heartbreaking to come that close to making the final two and not getting there.
Go! Coming up, Peter and Laura go head-to-head in a spectacular test of intelligence like you've never seen before.
Not right, not right.
Everything is on the line. Who will earn the title? Write them. Canada's smartest person.
All new Monday.
Love field trips.
Let's get on the bus.
8 hours spare today.
There's a few things you have to do.
They have to learn.
Take care of the kids.
Tour guides do that.
It's party day.
Mr. D, Monday at 8 on CBC. Kraft Hockeyville 2012. We're down to the top five communities. It's time, Canada, to pick a winner. Vote online and on your mobile device at crafthockeyville.ca or call toll-free. This year's winner will be announced on CBC's Hockey Night in Canada, March 31st, and get $100,000 in arena upgrades from Kraft, an NHL preseason game, and a visit from CBC's Hockey Night in Canada. Vote for your favorite community today. Brought to you in part by the Oriole 100th anniversary. Watch CBC's Monday Night lineup for your chance to win a dependable lineup of Maytag appliances. Look for the keyword during Maytag Mondays on CBC every week from 6:30 to 10 p.m. and go online to enter. Maytag, for great performances you can depend on.
Hi, sweetie. Your father and I thought we'd fly in for a surprise visit. So, surprise. We should be there by noon. Bye, dear.
Get cracking. Find recipes at eggsforenergy.ca.
Next up, get fit with Derek.
Get cracking. Find recipes at eggsforenergy.ca.
Introducing Kleenex Cool Touch Tissues. The only tissue that actively releases a cool sensation to soothe the nose on contact. Kleenex Cool Touch Tissues, a cool new way to soothe.
Come enjoy the ultimate tea house experience. The Pink Ivy Tea House is nestled in a quaint rural setting and ready to pamper. Indulge yourself and unwind in our aromatic tea room. Enjoy lunch outdoors, overlooking charming walkways and lush gardens. The Pink Ivy Tea House is an exotic place that serves fabulous food and a fine cup of tea. Discover the Pink Ivy Tea House in Richer, Manitoba. Visit us at thepinkivy.com.
Where'd all the junk go?
The junk's gone.
Not bad, huh? This kitchen's my favorite.
You've done a terrific job here. She gets a good rent.
We don't need a renter, Dad.
For me?
I guess so.
Life is better when you're prepared.
Ask your advisor how Manulife can help.
Hey.
If only everything came with Glad Odor Guard. Glad Kitchen Catcher garbage bags with Odor Guard help stop garbage smells in your home. Available on a variety of Glad garbage and recycling products.
I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back this feeling for so long.
This week on the Mercer Report, training with Olympic swimmers in Victoria, BC.
An all-new Rick Mercer Report, Tuesday at 8 on CBC.
I'm seeing like bait!
Straight ahead on The National, flight delays spread anger on a busy travel weekend, adding up the damage from a fiery St. Patrick's Day standoff, plus hard times for the young and the jobless.
Welcome back. We are just moments away from meeting Canada's smartest person. Tonight we've seen that being smart isn't just one thing. Each of us has strengths in different areas that makes us who we are. You two have made it to this moment because overall, you've tested the best. In some categories, you ruled, but in others, you might have just squeezed by. Well, no more squeezing by. This is the Multiple Intelligence Obstacle Course. This last challenge will determine which of you is the smartest because it will force you to shine in every area of intelligence. Whoever wins this race will be named Canada's smartest person. Finalists, take your spots at the starting line. Here's how it works. This obstacle course is a pressure-filled race that is broken down into five different stages that will challenge all of your smarts. First, you need to walk across the balance beam through the gap all the way to the end without falling off. Once you do that, you need to come over to the shapes table, put all the shapes together and into their proper slots until all of them are complete. After that, you head over to the math board. There's two equations on the math board, equation A and equation B. Once you've solved each one, add them up and put your final answer in here. Once I tell you that's complete and correct, you move up to the music section. Here, you will hear a sequence of notes that you will have to play back. Once you get it successfully, you can then move on to the word tiles. And once you get here, you have to successfully place 10 words on the board. And if you do that correctly, you come up here, you grab the horn, you blow it, and you will become Canada's smartest person. Are you ready?
Ready.
Ready.
Good luck to both of you. Three, two, one, go! Nice job. Put the bar back. You gotta go back, Peter, you gotta go back. It's not gonna happen quickly, it's not gonna happen quickly, so no, keep, take no. your time.
Take her easy, take her easy.
Okay.
Okay, Laura. Good start, good start. Go back. That was close, that was close. You don't have to force them in. As long as we see that it's in, you're fine.
Well, that's a circle.
That's it, Laura. That's it. Just get it in. Good. Good job, Peter. You're coming back. Okay, onto the mat. I will tell you if you get this right.
Defense! 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 Defense!
everybody. This is good exercise. You know, once you have the math, I'll let you know if it's right. If it's not right, go back and do it again. Not right, not right.
What? Oh, gosh. Oh. It's not 1831. It's not 1831.
That's not right.
Right. Yeah, I'm not giving up. I'm not giving up.
No, not right.
20. Oh. Ah. Oh. Ah, oh. Okay. Okay, okay.
What is it? No.
What?
Not right. Ah. Oh. That's right, good.
Please tell me that's right.
No, it's
what?
Not right, it's not right.
Still? Wait, that's still... What am I doing?
You got it. Come on, Laura, take your time. Laura, right to me. cbc.ca/smartestperson for more about multiple intelligences and to see how people from right across Canada did tonight. Thanks for playing and watching, and congratulations to Peter Diakowski from Vancouver. Good night, everybody.
CBC News The National starts now.
I'm Anne-Marie Meadows.